I recently went on a trip through Morocco. On my travels, I met some really talented artists and craftspeople. I included them in my travel videos, but I thought it would be really nice to showcase them together for those who missed it. In this video, we'll visit Ibriam, a fossil hunter in northern Morocco, Essaid, a musical instrument maker on the west coast, Mohammed, a traditional pharmacist in Fez, and Sonja, an artist in Essaouira who makes beautiful creations from the things she finds on the beach. Let me know which one you enjoyed most in the comments, and stay crazy positive.
Hello, Marianne. How are you? You're welcome. My name is Ibriam, geologist man, a crazy man stones, but positive. Positive crazy man, yes. This actually is one kind for ammonite snails. I found this in 9 meter ground, deep by hand. Found this between Middle Atlas and the Atlas Mountains. Then carted with diamond disc. Then you have this quality. Normally it was slain snail long time ago, between 70 and 210 million years ago. Like what you say here is you have sandrosa, sharksuse, trilobites. It's the mostly very old fossils we have in the world. It's trilobites in the world, not just in Morocco. The trilobites, it's mostly very old one, between 230 and 530 million of years ago. This kind of stones for fossils, the name of it is Sibtarian. I found this in Morocco too also. I found it like that, then cut it with diamond disc. Quartz diode, amethyst, vanadium, the red one, we find it in the mines, 25 meter ground, deep by hand. This coral, agate, pyrite, the red one, vanadium, that one, it's pyrite. False gold. We have also the blue one, azurite malachite, is oxidation of copper. We find it also in the mines.
How long have you been doing this?
Well, normally 17 years ago, this is my job. And my job, I'm learning by doing my job. Very hard job, but lovely things. When I found something beautiful, I feel more happy than. Anytime you want to come to Morocco and you want to look to try to find some, I'm here. I'm not crazy. I'm crazy positive. You're welcome.
How many years have you been making these?
I mean more than 34 years.
34?
Just making instrument, but wood before. 10 years before, like 44 years now.
Okay.
When I was a child, yeah, seven.
Did your family make these?
Yeah, uncles. Yeah.
Uncles.
Yes, two instruments in one. Yeah, drum.
Okay. And is this mother of pearl?
Yes.
Okay.
This is another print, wow. Yes. Yeah.
And the black?
The black one is the ebon and the lemon tree.
Lemon tree
lemon,
and ebony?
Yes.
And the main part is?
This is the mahogany.
Okay.
Mahogany.
Wow.
Yes.
That is an expensive instrument. It's a beautiful instrument.
The skin is from is the camel neck.
Okay.
Strings, the goat guts, camel and the goat.
It's amazing.
Yeah, handmade, no machine.
Breakfast, I went in search of a SIM card. The guy at the cafe showed me where to get one, then introduced me to his cousin, who works at a local pharmacy. So I went to take a look.
So this is what we call the Moroccan Berbersee. Mm-hmm. So this is a mixture of plants that we call the royal Berbersee for relaxing, for removing headache, for removing stress, also have for sleeping. As you see, it's a mixture of a lot of ingredients. For example, it has the anise. So this is the star of the anise. It has also the amber. So this is the amber, type of amber that we get it from the trees. It's like a glue that is came from the trees. This is the Moroccan ginseng. It has also the verbena. It has the sauge, or what can people call the salvia. And it has also the masses flower. So this is the masses flower and the hibiscus or the carcadi. And it has a few drops of saffron and the lemongrass. So it's all natural ingredients. Once you mix all those ingredients, you prepare the royal Berber tea. It's a tea for relaxing, for removing stress, removing headache. And people were using it for a long, long time ago. So this is the Berberian cultures. So like this, we're using it just with hot water. We don't add sugar, we don't add green tea, we don't add green mint, and we don't boil it also. Because once you boil the plants, it will be toxic. So like this, what do? We put it just with hot water and we let it for 2 minutes, a couple minutes like this. Then we filter it and you drink it. Then you can enjoy the Moroccan whiskey without alcohol. For giving energy, giving power, giving force. So
okay.
It's like natural Viagra.
Okay. It's tiny, isn't it? There are so many herbs and spices used in traditional Moroccan medicine. It takes years for someone to become truly proficient in mixing all of the preparations. One of the most famous preparations is argan oil.
So this is the traditional machine that we prepare with the argan. So what do? We put the seeds of the argan, as you see, so those are the seeds of the argan. We need to put it in here, in this hole right there.
Mm-hmm.
You can have a look in this hole. So you're gonna see, it's gonna be like stitchy inside. So what do? We round it like this. So once you turn it like this, the seeds of the argan is gonna crush. And we have some space in here. So like this is giving us the oil and the creams, both of them. So we filter them. We use the creams for the cosmetic products, for preparing the creams and something like this. And we keep the oil for making the argan oil for the skincare, and the argan oil for cooking or eating, and the argan that we prepare for medicines. So this is how we prepare the argan.
They say the seeds help control diabetes. I ate one and it was spicy like mustard. The oil is exported around the world for skincare and hair.
Once you take the oil, you take the cream, you take all of it, it's leaves.
And what do you do with it?
So with this one, we use this also for the cosmetic issue, and we're using it also for preparing something which is for cooking.
The shop also sells incense, and they showed me how to perform a Muslim cleansing ceremony.
Those are the rocks that we burn, crush them together, giving us this powder. So this powder we're using just like this, a small quantity, we put it on a piece of carbon. So you see? Like this. So once you burn it, it's giving us so those incense for perfume in the house, also for protecting from the devils.
Mm-hmm.
It's for protecting from the devils and the bad luck. It's gonna do with the ceremonies, the thing that we do for protecting. You need to turn it on your head, relax like this, it will came off on you and give you the good luck and all the things like this. We're using it every Friday.
Okay.
Every Friday we're using it. Also, it's like a Ghostbuster.
Uh-huh. So it's a special one for Eid.
Yeah. This one is need a while to burn. So this one, you can see, it's just a type of rose. So we need to make it wet like this. So this is the coquelicot, this is the effects of the coquelicot. We need to rub it like this in our hand. You can see how it's coming. So red. So like this, we use this as a lipstick, we're using this also on the cheeks to make them red, we're using it also at the back of the legs.
Mm-hmm.
You can use it as a way.
After brunch, we headed off for a walk and stumbled across this lovely art studio run by artist Sonja Georgeson, who has lived in Essaouira for 8 years. She produces wonderful works of art, including cards, notebooks and collages, as well as selling artist supplies.
Number 14.
Mm-hmm.
It's the 14th one I've made.
That's beautiful.
Artist books that I make. This one about Essaouira.
That's really beautiful.
Using a combination of mixed media and printmaking and paintings and lino cuts, magazine pieces, ink and wax crayon. Profile of Mogador Island and a Tuareg veil weight and Murex shell, which references the Murex that used to be produced here, the purple dye used to be produced here, BC. Some sardines, of course, the lion, for the Atlas lion, it's extinct now. The hoopoe, which is an honoured bird here, and the Tuareg cross is a symbol of Solomon. And we have finds from the beach and more finds from the beach and more finds from the beach.